Do I need the mic?
Okay, so this is a new thing we're trying out in our meetups. We prepared some interesting Git-related exercises, probably things that you don't use very often, but you know, you come across them in your life as a programmer, and Git can help you with certain things. So what I want you all to do is, if you have a laptop, bring it out. If you don't have a laptop, you might be able to carry this off with github.com on your phone, or you might not. Maybe. Let's see if you can. So we have made the exercises such that there are multiple correct ways of solving them. So if you can come up with like some really cool hacks to do that, that would be awesome. So any JavaScript developers in the room? Okay, not bad. Anybody heard of this library called underscore.js? Okay, it's just a small utility library with a lot of functions for operating mostly on collections, so like map, reduce, all that stuff. So we're going to be looking at that library, clone it, or if you want to use GitHub, you don't have to clone it, but then I expect like some really cool answers out of you. I can see Sebastian. So I can show you the library, what it looks like. Basically, their source contains a lot of files related to building and stuff, and this is the main one, underscore.js, and it's just published as underscore.js. And it's a JavaScript file which has all the various functions that underscore is capable of, like iterate, underscore.each. So everything, it's a flat structure, everything is just in one file. It's not built up of multiple modules. So the questions will be related to doing something with this file. Cloning done?
Done.
You didn't do anything.
I forked it.
Okay. Let's see where you go with that. Okay. So underscore has one utility function called underscore.groupby. It's used to take in a collection and some parameters, and then you group them together based on whatever function you pass in. So we don't care about that. What we care about is, when was underscore.groupby first introduced in the underscore.js source? And by the way, we have stickers to give out. We have octocaps and other things from GitHub. So you have about, let's say, 5 minutes? 5 minutes. And yeah, let's see how fast. Who's the first person to come up with the answer? Which revision was underscore.groupby introduced in?
Group repositories are not currently searchable.
You can find an answer on GitHub, by the way.
It is possible to actually find this using GitHub.
It's just difficult.
Yeah. It depends. If you really know GitHub well and you don't know the Git tool really well, then you can. Yeah. Let's see. Sebastian, we're expecting some greatness. What was the commit ID?
Fuck you, man.
I gotta delete that out.
F8A4B78.
Okay, let me verify that. Thank you. found it? Okay. Is it the same as what Sebastian said?
What did you say?
F8A4B78.
I don't, you need a date? Oh, reading or reading.
Okay, date?
Oops, okay, now I found a date.
Okay, try to find the revision.
Alright.
And then we will have Sebastian and you demo your solutions. Anyone else? Except for CJ? Organizers not allowed to tell the answers. Anyone wants a hint? Anyone using the git command line to find the answer? Okay. You don't have to come back.
I could do it through Travis.
Okay, if you're using the command line, look into git log. Okay, CJ also has another tip. You can probably also use git blame to find this out.
That's what I did.
Okay. Sebastian, since you're ready with your answer, why don't you share how did you arrive?
Can you ask me?
I'll open GitHub here.
Okay.
So
yeah, I use the desktop side obviously. Mobile sites, I can't really do much.
Okay.
So I searched this repository, the top,
uh-huh,
for group by.
Okay. Forgot how to type. Hang on.
How do you type?
Okay.
So in the code, yeah, and then I went and looked for the tests.
Tests.
So
did you search for tests or?
Yeah, I think it's the first or the second one. It might be the first one, actually. Yeah, test collections, yeah, that's what I looked at.
Okay.
So I figured it would change less frequently.
Uh-huh.
And then at the top there, you can do blame.
Okay, so in this?
If I do blame, yeah. Uh-huh. It would tell me each line, which when it was committed and which commit. And I searched for group by, and a couple of, so this is January 20th, so unlikely, and I went down a couple more.
Okay.
Just keep searching for group by. So see all the way at the bottom, there's a whole cluster of them. That's pretty much where a major change related to group by was done. And I saw added in group by. So
okay.
I figured that's most likely.
Okay. You can have some octocats for yourself.
Awesome.
Do you want them now? Or?
Yeah.
Choose.
All right.
Okay, cool. Yeah, that works. So you can use GitHub to find out stuff like this. Do you want to share your...
Just in the command line.
Okay, wait, I have the command line somewhere. Okay. Git log.
And then dash dash grep.
Dash?
Dash double dash.
Grep?
Yeah, and then you just...
Group. Like that?
Yeah, yes.
Okay.
And then just go to the bottom.
Go to the bottom.
Yeah,
the same group. No. Okay.
So, there's a commit.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, and it's the same one. Nice. So, can you tell us a bit more about what is this grep option do?
Alright, so initially I wanted to use the grep that is come with the bash,
mm-hmm,
to do a Python grep.
Mm-hmm. But then I realized that it only gave me one line. So okay. I Google it, and that's the OSG treatment program. Yeah. So basically, it's just a screen for you.
Okay. But some fast Googling, by the way. Okay, you can have some stickers for yourself. Any other answers? Any alternative solutions? CJ? Yeah, go ahead.
Dash L.
Sorry?
Dash L.
Dash L?
Block dash L.
Wait. Oh my god, what did I do?
That's more complicated. Wow, that's some serious
commitment. Yeah. Well, what did you tell me to do? You crashed the computer back.
I think the cable might be good at being logical.
No, I pressed the power button by mistake.
What's on my
head? Okay, we will be back in 3.
But I have figured out how to use it, so.
0. Come on.
So, is there a way to trace the history of a particular line through a file or something?
Yeah, that's more technical, sorry.
Yeah.
I have to figure out how to use it. Okay.
So git, you're saying git log dash L.
Dash L, uppercase
L. Uppercase L. Okay. Yeah,
let's break and smash. Groupify.
Like that?
Yes. And then column.
Okay.
And I'm so
perfect. It's really hard to type when you put like that. Okay.
Okay, this is how far I got it.
Okay.
That's a lot of text.
So what does dash L do?
According to the population, it's tracing the evolution of the line range or ways.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
that was a bit more information.
We reached the first commit. Yeah, might be something that CJ?
Dash capital S.
Dash capital S.
Git log.
Git log dash capital S.
Goodbye.
True. Bye. Okay. And then?
Just go to the bottom.
Okay, yeah. So, how is this dash capital S different from grep?
Can you show the main file?
Yeah.
Git help log.
Okay. Grep is this one. Can you explain it to us?
So, grep searches the git commit this message, while dash S searches the patch itself. So, there are times where you want to look at the commit messages, sometimes you want to look at the code patches itself. So that's where the difference really is. Can you do a dash S with a dash P so that you can show the patch?
Okay.
Let's go, yeah.
Okay.
So this is showing the patch, and because this particular commit has both the group by in the commit message as well as the code itself, the last commit will show up.
So dash S will actually look through the file and the stuff that you changed?
Yeah.
And grep will just look at the message?
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. You can have some AutoCAD sticker if you need them. Okay, pretty cool. Okay, so now we have. That was the first exercise. The second one may or may not be a little easier. So what happens to me a lot is that I'm looking through a library and I think I found a bug and then I find out that they fixed the bug. Now I want to know that, do I have this fix in the version of the library that I'm using? Or is it in a newer version? When did they actually publish this fix to the world? So for example, in underscore there was a bug and then you can see the status, it's closed. So they fixed it, and if you look on GitHub, they fixed it in this commit. So it says it fixes 1189, which is the ID of the issue there. So they fixed this, but the commit message itself doesn't tell me which release of underscore this happened in. So your job is to find out which version of underscore.js, you know, like 1, 2, 3, whatever, this fix was introduced in. And you can try to use GitHub for this, or the command line, whatever you feel. If you want the SHA-ID of the commit, it's 14C3F9. By the way, if on GitHub you want to see what are the various releases of underscore, you can see that right here. So if you go to the project homepage, then under releases you have the various releases that they've made. And as a hint, you can also see that you can find those releases as tags in their repository. May or may not help you. They have a lot of releases from 0.1.0 to 1.8.3.
What's this?
This. Okay, yes. Okay, and did you use the command line or GitHub?
Yes.
Okay, do you want to share your solution?
Yes.
Let me open the command line. Alright, you didn't see that?
Yeah,
okay.
Git tag.
Git?
Yes.
Okay. Are you sure? Okay. So what does this tell us?
It shows which tag commits this.
Okay, so how do you know it's 1.5.2 and not 1.8.1?
That's the first one.
Okay. Yeah, that works. Pretty cool. GitHub stickers. Yes, Sebastian, the GitHub way of doing this.
I sort of URL hacked to the commit.
Okay.
So when you go to like Git,
yeah.
So if you click on my like latest commit there, the B30 E40 E.
This?
Yeah. Like if I click here,
okay.
It puts the hash there. So I put that partial hash in there, and it sort of works.
This guy?
Yeah.
Okay. And then?
Git is awesome. So it tells me 1.5.2.
Very clever. Do you want a different OptoCat?
Yes.
Okay, cool. That's it for these two exercises. I have a bonus exercise later, but we'll do that after the talk. Okay. So now we have CJ for a talk about git config.